Hello, we're Oomph, and you're watching Midator. Stay tuned, motherfuckers.
I think it's a fourth experience for you with a symphonic orchestra in total. But you never played before with a Russian orchestra. So can you tell a bit about your experience with particularly this orchestra, and how did it come about, and what are your feelings about that?
That's the good thing about the language of music. If you know the keys and the notes, it's a universal language. So it's cool to see that there's an orchestra which just looks at the sheets, plays, and everything works. Mm-hmm. You know, that's a really good thing about music. It knows no borders, and that's really cool. And yeah, people are really nice and friendly. And the conductor knows German, which is good. Mm-hmm. I'm really looking forward to it.
The thing is, most of good orchestras can play like everybody can read a book or a text, but it depends on how you read the text. You can read it like a robot, hello, I am sitting here, or you can interpret it with emotions like an actor. And this is the main thing what we talked about in the rehearsals, how to interpret what is written there. And what we feel is that Russians have the same melancholy in his heart like it is in our music. So it was pretty easy for them to understand what we want to transport with the music. It's the orchestra is Globalis from Moscow. Mm-hmm. And it was easy to work with them. The rehearsals went very good.
I've been talking to you about half a year ago, right after Leipzig concerts.
All right.
And you told me that you had some challenging experience because you were rehearsing in one place and then you were playing in a different place.
Like this so time.
Is that the same situation now?
Yeah? Right, yeah. Usually you don't have the possibility to rehearse in the same area because it's booked, you know. The huge halls are booked each day for another event. So we did the rehearsal in a smaller location. But it was more intimate and you could hear everything pretty well.
So it was good.
It was in Moscow. Oh,
okay.
Yesterday,
yeah. So that was awesome. So yeah, we're looking forward to this location, to this concert hall. And it will sound differently, of course, but well, never mind. Hopefully it's gonna sound even better than it sounded yesterday. I really think so.
And the question towards you guys, I understand that with vocals it's pretty much different to sing along with an orchestra, but how do you as like people who play instruments
It's the same, I think. It's the same for everybody as with a vocal or an instrument. On the one hand, you have to concentrate on your own instrument that you are playing, and it doesn't matter if it's a guitar or if it's a vocal or a keyboard. And on the other hand, you have the other musicians that you have to play together with. It's, mm-hmm. You're not playing alone, so you have to bring both together. And now it's for the first time, or not for the first time, as you said, for the fourth time, but we have different music in our ears and different dynamics, and the orchestra is playing much more dynamic with more volume up or down and other interpretations like we are used to hear the songs. So it's totally new, and so that's why the sound check is very important to get used to it.
Mm-hmm. And it's much more to see for us on stage. Mm-hmm. Because there are so much people on stage, that's also not normal for us. Mm-hmm. There are moments where the orchestra is playing very long intros and or outros, and that are the moments where we also enjoy what happened there on stage. Mm-hmm. That we can lay back and look what happened there with our music and the interpretation of the orchestra of our music.
And how does it feel in terms of like atmosphere and vibe, in terms of the communication with the audience? Like, is it easier? Is it harder?
I think it's different. That's what it is, and it has to be different. Mm-hmm. I think it's more introvert as it is as a usual rock show. The feelings are felt more inside than outside. So, but that what makes it special. I mean, it has to be different. People dress differently when they usually go to classical concerts. And it belongs to that, and everything belongs to this event. that what makes it special. And of course, I will act differently than on a usual rock show, and it would be strange if I would act exactly the same. It causes different emotions, even with me. So that means that I will act differently. As I said, more intimate, more concentrated on my insight. So yeah, but that doesn't mean that it's less emotions. It's just different emotions. Mm-hmm. That what makes it special.
Yeah. Today will be for the first time that we play with a classical orchestra, and we have a mix.
Fourth time.
No, listen to what I wouldn't want to say afterwards. Be patient.
I know what you want to say.
Sure.
It's the first time that we have a standing fan area in front of us when we play with a classical orchestra. The times before, it was everybody seated.
Did they stood up during the concert?
Sometimes, some of them. But then you have those in the back who are saying, I paid for an expensive seat. Sit down, I cannot see anything. So sometimes they will stand up and dance, of course. But now we have about 1,500 people standing in the fan area. So let's see how it will be different than the shows before. It will be pretty interesting.
Well, speaking of that, like speaking of this, all this kind of classical music approach, when I was talking with you a half a year ago, and I asked you if you wanted to try something new in terms of music, which you never tried before, and you said you wanted to try singing opera.
Yeah, that would be great. So, that would be awesome. I would really like to do that. It's really special, and it's a challenge, and it's hard, and difficult. That's the best for a singer. I mean, if you make this, if you'll be able to do that, wow. Yeah, that would be great. If I would have the opportunity to do that, just even for one song, I would do that. Yeah, but yeah, we did some new approaches on music even within our new CD, which is gonna come out at the 18th of January in 2019, which is gonna be our 13th album, by the way. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we went back with the time machine in the middle of the 90s, mm-hmm. and tried to feel again what we felt back then. Try to mix it with our actual status quo of mind, heart, and soul, and that's new about OOMPH. We never went back before and took some phases of our history and took it where we are right now, mm-hmm. and that's what makes the new album special. It's going to be really hard, provocative, dark, deep, and it deals with much really heavy topics.
You can't uncover the title yet?
The title?
No. It's still a secret, sorry.
It's not called It's Still a Secret, sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe title of the record.
And I'm planning to go with any dates in Russia with it?
Sure. Yeah. First we'll tour Germany, Austria, Switzerland and Europe. But at the end of 2019 we plan to come back to Russia for even more shows than last time. Hopefully more Far East shows, that would be great, Vladivostok, Novosibirsk, something like that. That would be awesome, because it's a huge country and we didn't see too much, unfortunately, yet. So there's so many new cities for us to explore.
Mm-hmm. I watched, for this interview, some of your interviews, recent ones, and found a small conflict of interest between you guys, because I remember in one place you said that you wanted to go on a Trans-Siberian railway touring one city after another, and you once said that you did not like the trains because you can't sleep on them, so
That's
you'd
true.
Rather not tour via train. So how would you resolve that?
I don't know. Maybe we can also, we can only travel by day, mm-hmm. and sleep at night in hotels. I don't know how to solve this problem, but usually I cannot sleep at all in trains. That's a problem. I like traveling by train during the days, but at night it's sheer horror for me. Mm-hmm. So
what we thought about that?
Yeah, sure.
If we talk about the shows, and we talk about the shows in direction Vladivostok, we thought about that we go by train, mm-hmm. over day and go in the night in the hotel, and could be.
Mm-hmm. Why not?
It would be very great to see the country from this side.
Yeah, I mean, it's more meditative way to look at it. Yeah.
That's right.
And do you have any plans with the orchestra in the future, or like maybe extending it to to Russia as well? Like
actually, we're going to play in the Ukraine, in Kiev, in February 2019. With the same set and with a new Ukrainian orchestra.
But you won't be playing new songs,
though. No, that's always different and difficult and strange for us. If you play songs that no one knows right now, it's not good for the mood. You know, everybody's sitting there. What's that? Okay, yeah, that was great, but that's strange. So yeah, we like playing songs that people know, can sing along.
But maybe they will know by February already, because you are...
It's only 1 month.
It's only 1 month.
No, not enough?
No. Mm-hmm. And you need preparation time for it. There has to be the arrangements, has to be written, the orchestra has to do rehearsals. And
yeah. No. And if I'm not mistaken, you changed your label, is it correct?
That's right. We're now at Napalm Records.
Was that decision taken, and how do you feel about it now? Or?
Well, contracts end. At some time, and then you have to find a new record label. Mm-hmm. We made the classical thing, like demo tapes, and talked to all of the most important labels in Germany. Mm-hmm. And we had offers from 8 big labels, and we've chosen Napa Records because they seem to think the most like we think of the future of Umf.
And the good thing is that it's the first time that we got a worldwide release. Mm-hmm. We even released officially in Russia via Soyuz Records. So yeah, that's a good thing, yeah, to release in Japan and America, wherever, at the same time. And that's the first time, because in the past we just had deals in Europe, let's say Europe, and yeah, it was a bit concentrated on this small part of the world. As we know, we have many fans all over the world. It's a good thing to release the new album worldwide. We're looking forward to it very much.
Cool. Okay, so last question. I know that you're one of those bands who actually really work with the audience in terms of different approaches. And I know that usually you have different VIP packages for fans to buy. How did you guys have this idea? And if it's like your idea or if it's management?
People just demanded it in the past, and we just didn't deliver it because we said it was not necessary. And there were more and more people said asking, please offer special tickets. I want to get to know you. I want to take part in the sound check, whatever. Please do it. And we said, really, can we deliver this? We talked it over pretty intensively and came to the result, if they want to do it, we offer it. So it was, of course, our choice. And yeah, we decided pretty well which organization can deliver this. And yeah, people like it, appreciate it very well that they can buy those tickets, those upgrades. And yeah, we feel that it's good. If we can offer this service for them, why not?
The thing is, nothing has changed how we act with fans. If we meet them on the airport or at the hotel, we still give autographs, sign things for free, and we talk to them as before. It's a chance if they meet us or not.
Yeah.
And for those who want to have it guaranteed to meet us, to ask us questions or to give us presents or whatever, now they have the opportunity to buy it if they want it. So that's the only thing that changed.
And there's still official fan club meetings, because we have fan clubs all over the world, and if the official Russian fan club says we want to have a meet and greet, we do this for free, of course, still as we always did.
Or at festivals, like
right.
We do it also
right,
1 hour.
So nothing has changed at all, just a plus
yeah.
For those who want to buy this. Why not?
No, I totally love it. I just think it's a great idea.
Sure.
And of course, what is happening in those different meet and greets is a suggestion of the company Treehouse Ticketing, because they have the experience with Ministry and Tokyo Hotel and other artists. What fans could like and what's useless to do or to offer, and so we talk with them about it and just tried it. And we change little things and listen to the fans what they want to have in the next package.
We edit now the sex, right?
Psst.
Okay.
It's a secret offer.
Okay.